Recommendation or movie review of the week. Today it's going to be a bit of a delayed movie because it came out last year, but it was by my favorite director John Woo, and the movie, one of my favorite action directors, and the movie is Silent Night.
Wait, you said what? It came out when?
Last year. It was a Christmas movie, yeah. That's why it was called Silent Night, because it also fit in with the theme of the song. So it's the movie, sorry, the theme of the movie. So for those of you that haven't watched it, the movie is basically about a guy on a revenge streak after he lost his son to gang violence. A stray bullet unalived his son, and he was going after the gangsters, and one of the gangsters got to him and actually shot him in the neck, and he survived. So he can't talk, but he can't talk. And the whole movie, no one speaks, confirm. No one speaks on screen. Confirm. No one speaks on screen. Like, there were people, like, radio chatter, people speaking on radio, people speaking on TV, but no one actually spoke on screen, which ties in, again, as a double entendre, into the theme, Silent Night. Because he doesn't speak, and no one is, it's not like no one is talking in the movie, but they did it in a way that they don't capture anyone talking in the movie.
What do you think about
the movie? It was a concept that I felt was not meant for John Woo.
Okay, what do you think about the movie?
I feel it was a letdown for me, man. That whole not speaking concept, it took away a little bit too much for me from the movie. I appreciate the concept, but I wasn't really fulfilled by the execution. The action sequences were dope, though. They were dope. They were, I mean, the guy was human. He wasn't, like, invincible, like John Wick or what's his name from The Beekeeper, you know? He wasn't invincible, you know? I watched, like, 2 seconds of The Bricklayer. I didn't bother.
I fell asleep.
I saw it was a low budget. People stop comparing The Beekeeper with The Bricklayer.
No, it wasn't low budget.
No, but why are people comparing the two?
But you can't say it's low budget.
It felt too low budget for me.
No, it wasn't low budget.
Anyway.
You should have watched the whole movie.
Anyway. Did you watch it?
I watched it.
You said you fell asleep.
I did, and I watched it again. I woke up and watched it again.
Okay, I'll try to watch it, and then we'll give a review next week.
But, okay.
But that's an old... But yes. Anyway, like I said...
Silent Night.
Back to Silent Night. Okay. I watched it because John Woo is one of my favorite. I mean, he did Appleseed, the anime, the Japanese. He did Con Air, and he did Face Off. Face Off.
Coming.
Oh, gosh. He also did Hot Target, Van Damme.
Yeah, Hot Target, that was dope.
You remember? Yeah,
What about Broken Arrow? Who did Broken Arrow?
I don't know. I don't know if it's John Woo. Who did Broken Arrow? That's the one with Christian Slater, yeah?
Mm.
Yeah, that's about the stolen missile.
Mm.
That was a dope movie. I'll put the director here for Broken Arrow. I don't remember. If it's John Woo, then it's John Woo. If it's not, there's the director. Like I was saying, the concept itself, I felt it was dope. I get what they were trying to do. But I felt like for the kind of movie it was, it needed some kind of dialogue.
Well, okay.
Because the wife didn't even speak, fam.
Yeah,
even though she was speaking, but they made it in a way that you don't hear her on screen.
No, she wasn't. She wasn't speaking at all. She was typing.
Yeah, because there were times when she would just look at him and just...
Yeah, she was typing,
and
writing
just walk
notes,
away. Yeah.
And there's this weird thing about... what's his name? Kid Cudi?
Kid Cudi was totally terrible in that movie.
But, like, the movie itself...
And why is his lip so black?
I don't know, bro.
Like, it looked like he had black lipstick on.
But the movie itself, I think the story itself, it's not
cliche.
It's not a
nothing new.
It's not a concrete story.
It's a solid story, but it's been told before.
Nah, it's not a concrete story.
It's shallow.
Let's say it's
shallow.
And then, like, okay, yes, the action sequences, they were dope. But at some point in time, I lost track of the time frame of the actual movie. Because he goes on this, starts to train, trying to go after the bag.
But he got his ass handed to him by the first dude.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
no, but that
I lost,
just...
I lost track of...
No, but like, I like that because they showed the vulnerability of
him.
He's still just a father at the end of the day.
But you don't make people lose track of timeline as to when he started training and then... like how many months or how many years or after. We don't know.
Oh yeah, because his target was to get at them on the 20 December. Was it 24?
Just before Christmas.
Yeah, Christmas Eve.
He gave himself a year.
The following year, yeah.
He gave himself a year, but then in the actual movie, I don't know.
Like months were passing by.
You can't tell.
There was a bit of a break there. The action sequences,
yes, they were dope.
It's John Woo.
I like the main actor. What's his name? I'm forgetting him.
That's his name.
He was the one on Altered Carbon, the first season.
I thought I knew his face.
He's the same guy who's on Mute. There's another movie similar to actually John Woo's. It's called Mute.
Okay.
Watch that one. That one they executed it perfectly.
Okay.
All right. So, yeah, it had things going for it, and then it had things working against it. Like that whole Kid Cudi debacle agent type, they should have just removed it.
The movie can happen without. No hate towards Kid Cudi.
No hate towards him.
His character
was not. Yeah. He was irrelevant to the whole plot.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, 4 out of 10.
I'm giving it a 3.5 out of 10. Bryan Willis movie review. Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Movie of the song of the week.
So that's it for movie of the week. Now we move on to song of the week.